First of all, pelvis. It is, you need to found all types of articulations. For example, dart roses, which joint do you know between sacral and iliac bone? Sacroiliac joint. Articulatio sacroiliaca. Is it simple or compound?
Simple,
because two bones participate here. It is fascis auricularis of sacral bone and the same in iliac bone. It is simple, plain, combined, and it is tight joint or amphiarthrosis. That is why we don't discuss movements in this joint. That is a joint. Now, synarthrosis subdivides into syndesmosis, synchondrosis, synostosis. Syndesmosis, they are ligaments in sacroiliac joint. They are ligamenta sacroiliaca dorsalia, ligamenta sacroiliaca ventralia, ligamenta sacroiliaca interossa, very strong ligaments between tuberositas iliaca and tuberositas sacralis. The same we have ligament between spinal process of fifth lumbar vertebra and iliac crest, that is ligamentum iliolumbale. Iliolumbale. Another it is between transverse process, that is transverse processes of fifth lumbar and iliac crest. Between fifth lumbar and iliac crest. Ligamentum iliolumbale. Then ligamentum sacrospinale between sacral bone and spina ischiasica, and ligamentum sacrotuberale between sacral bone and tuberous ischiasicum. And these two ligaments, together with notches, greater and lesser sciatic notch, makes two openings. Here it is foramen ischiasicum major, and here it is foramen ischiasicum minor. Next, another two ligaments we can found in pubic symphysis. Above of pubic symphysis we have ligamentum pubicum superior and below ligamentum arcuatum pubis. And membrane in pelvis, that is membrana obturatoria. It closed obturator foramen, and between this membrane and sulcus obturatorius we have canal, canalis obturatorius. Temporary synchondrosis in pelvis, they are synchondrosis between iliac, sciatic and pubic bone, and they fuse together and we receive os coxa, hip bone. And whole pelvis include sacral bone and coccygeal bone. That is why synchondrosis between sacral vertebrae and synchondrosis between coccygeal vertebrae, they also continues into synostosis, and we receive os sacrum and os coccygeus. And last type of articulation, that is pubic symphysis. Between two symphyseal surfaces, we have cartilage, that is discus interpubicus. And this cartilage has cavities, that is why it is not synchondrosis, but symphysis. That is all. Next, maybe you know that pelvis subdivides into large pelvis and small or true pelvis. And border between them, that is linea terminalis. This line consists of promontorium, linea arcuata, eminence iliopubica, pecten osseus pubis, and upper border of pubic symphysis. And here it is the same. That is a line which is separate a large pelvis and true pelvis. And you need to know sizes of large pelvis and sizes of true pelvis. Why it is important to know? Because in time of pregnancy, you need to decide, is it possible delivery of fetus normally or necessary to make cesarean section if pelvis is narrow. That is why first size, that is space between superior anterior iliac spine, that is distance interspinarum, from here to here, it should be 25-27 centimeters. That is normal. next size, that is distance between iliac crests, distance intercrestarum, should be 28, 29 centimeters. Mm-hmm. Next, size between greater trochanter, from here to here, and this distance should be 31, 32 centimeters. Next, external direct size, that is space between pubic symphyses and point below of a spinal process of fifth lumbar, here it is, from here to here, that is conjugata externa, should be 21 centimeters. And if we minus from this size 10 centimeters, we receive true conjugate, conjugata vera, that is space between promontorium and middle part of pubic symphysis, should be 11 centimeters. Transverse size of pelvic inlet, that is, we can found if we divide distance intercrestarum into two. For example, if this distance is 28 or 29 centimeters, mm-hmm. and we divide into two, we receive 14 and a half centimeters, that is transverse size of pelvic inlet. Direct size of pelvic outlet from lower part of pubic symphysis and apex of coccygis, os coccygis, that is direct size of pelvic outlet, should be 11 centimeters, the same, and distance between inner surfaces of tuberous sciaticum should be between bones, that is 11 centimeters. Mm-hmm. But soft tissues, skin and subcutaneous fat, here it is the same present, that is why together with skin and fat, here it is 9 centimeters. Mm-hmm. Sorry. And last, that is hip joint. Hip joint.
Here, this angle?
That is angulus infrapubicus, and it has ligament, ligamentum arcuatum pubis. Mm-hmm. Now, joint between femur and acetabulum, that is hip joint, articulatio coxa. This joint is simple because consists of two articular surfaces. It is ball and socket and multi-axial. In frontal axis we make flexion and extension, in sagittal abduction and adduction, and in vertical axis pronation and supination. Circumduction the same is possible. This joint has two intra-articular ligaments. Do you remember which joint, which you already know, the same has intra-articular ligament? Between
head of the rib
and nearest vertebra, in compound joint of the head of the rib, that is ligamentum capitis costa intra-articulare. Yes, you're right. And another joint, that is a hip joint, articulatio coxa. Here it is between fossa acetabuli and fovea capitis femoris. We have ligamentum capitis femoris. It is very important ligament because through this ligament blood vessels goes to the head of the femur. Mm-hmm. And in time of fracture of the neck of the femur, if this ligament broken, this fracture not fused together. Is it clear mm-hmm. for you?
Yeah.
If this ligament not broken, in this case had it fused with neck like normally,
yeah.
But if this ligament broken, necessary to remove head of the femur and insert artificial head in this joint. Another intra-articular ligament, that is ligamentum transversum acetabuli, it is above of incisura acetabuli.
Mm-hmm.
And four extra-articular ligaments. Three of them very easy to answer because they start from three bones and attach to femur. For example, from iliac bone start ligamentum iliofemorale. From pubic bone ligamentum pubofemorale. And from sciatic bone ligamentum ischiofemorale. And one ligament, that it's like loop surround neck of the femur. It starts from spina iliaca anterior inferior and surround neck of the femur. That is zona orbicularis. Zona orbicularis. It's surround head and neck of the femur. That is hip joint. Next time, joints of pelvis. Pelvis as a whole. That is sizes of pelvis and hip joint.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you, sir.